Yeah, what is the problem for today that we need to solve? Shopping cart. This assignment is to build a shopping cart class analogous to your online shopping. Yes. The item class. He's saying there's a class called item. Each item will have information like product name, quantity and price. This class will have three variables, which is name, quantity and unit price. Yes. Next, there's another class called shopping cart. User should be able to do the following operations on the cart. That means for this class object, he need to perform all these functionalities. Yes. Okay, what is the first functionality? Add to catalog. Add an item to the catalog. What is catalog here? What do you think catalog is? What do you think the catalog is? Yes. Catalog is similar to when you open any e-cart, you will get which are the items present, what is the price of them, the quantity and all. Like that, here also you will have a catalog. That means what are the items that are available for selling. Okay? Yeah. That you can consider as store items or store details. Yes? Okay. Whenever you say add to catalog, then the argument passed to it is of item type. That object need to be added to your catalog. Yes? And what do you think your catalog, if it is a variable, what kind it should be? It should be array or only just a variable? Array, because our catalog might have any number of elements, any number of items, sorry. Yes? So that's why we'll consider a catalog object variable as array. Okay, there is another function called add to cart. This is taking the argument of item. Add the item to the cart. What is cart here? Yeah, whenever we select the items, our items will be added to the cart. This is individual specific. That means we need to perform the operation saying add. That means there are elements present in the catalog. Based upon the quantity of a product present, you need to add them to your cart. Okay, that is this functionality. Remove from cart. Here the argument passed is item itself. Yes. And remove the item from the cart. That means he is saying that when we add items to the cart, we can remove items from the cart also. Here you have two scenarios where there is a variable called quantity also for every item. Yes. If, for example, if I add eggs of size 10 items, if I say remove only 5 eggs, I should just reduce the count till 5. If I say remove 10 eggs, then the object should be removed from the list, from the cart itself. Yes, it is similar to your online scenario. Show cart means whatever items you added to your cart, those should be shown to you. Yes, that is the functionality of this. Display all the items in the cart with item name and quantity. These two arguments, variables should be shown. Show catalog. Show catalog will display all the items in the catalog with item name, quantity and price. Three will be provided. Okay? Yes. Get payable amount. Get the payable amount by deducting the discount, if any, and add tax 15% to the total amount of items in the cart. Yes. Get payable amount will be your final amount. That means if you have pushed 10 items to your cart, you will have a grand total for that. For that, if there is any discount, you need to first perform that discount, and then on the remaining amount that you need to pay, you need to add 15% tax to that. That will return your payable amount, final amount that you need to pay after discount as well as the tax. Okay? And here for discount, following are the discount percentages which need to be deducted from the total amount. That means there are 4, 10, 20, 30 and 50. Here, these are valid coupons. He is specifically saying these are valid coupons. If other coupons are given other than this, it should print invalid coupon. Okay? if any coupon is applied, then other than these four, it should say invalid coupon. Okay? Right. Apply coupon is one function. Whenever we say coupon, and that means this function will help us in applying the discount to the grand total. Okay? Print invoice will be your final print. That means what are the elements that are items that are present in your cart, what are the price of each, and what are the quantities. You will get your total for all those that are present in the cart. Then you will make a discount based upon the discount coupon. Next, you will perform the taxation for the remaining amount. Then sum up and give your final grand total. That is the payable amount. Okay. Displays all the items with quantity, unit price, total amount and payable amount. Apply coupon if valid. Okay. Instructions. First line contains number of lines. Following are the different options. Item catalog. Item. Add an item to your catalog. Item is the function that need to be added to your catalog. He is saying to use a array for it, as there will be multiple items. Catalog displays all the items in the catalog. Add an item to the cart array. Show display all the items in the cart. Total amount, display the total amount. This total amount will not have the reduced discount or the taxation. It will be calculating only the amount, whatever items that you placed in your cart, for them it will be calculating and returning it. Payable amount, for the total amount, existing total amount, it will apply the discount, then taxation, that will lead to your payable amount. Remove the items from the cart. Coupon, apply coupon code. Print the invoice in the following format. This should be your format. Okay. These are your sample inputs, and underneath you have your sample outputs. Yes. Okay. We'll go to our code. This is a solution.java class, public class solution. I have a main. Yes. Now what should I do first? First thing, what should I do? I'll open the first test case. Remember, when you are started to solve the problem, start working on the first input file. Yes, now I have my data. Now, what should I do? Yeah, before that, what should I do? First, I need to scanner SC is equal to new scanner of system dot in. Yes, I need to import it to work, right? Import java dot util dot scanner. Yes, here what I'll say is I'll write code and I'll again explain it. Dot has next println of SC dot next line function. Yeah, save, compile, compilation is done. I'll go to the Java solution less than test cases less than input. Am I able to read all the files? Yes. What am I doing in my code here? I created an object for scanner. What this sc.hasNext will say is, in your input file, the cursor will be checking if there is data after that. If it is, then it goes into the loop. If not, it will terminate from the loop. That's what happens. Now I have this. What I'll do, I'll store this into string input equal to, I'll say, yes. Now I'll take another. Okay, I have this data. I am reading all the data into input in the while loop. How can I split this data? How can I split them based upon the functions? Space or comma? Just think about it properly. With space or comma? By using space, I'll get only item as one and this as second. Yes? I'll check only items in the switch case. Based upon that, I'll perform operations on this data on the right side. Yes? What I'll do is string array of what should we name it? Tokens, okay. Tokens equal to input dot split by space. Done. Now I'll write switch case of tokens of 0. Yes. Now what are the cases that are present here? We'll be writing first them. Case item. Yes. Break. Next, another case that we have, catalog. 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 Next, add. Yes. Next, show. Next, total amount. Next, remove. Next, show is already present, total is present, payable amount is not there. Payable, AMOUNT. Yes. Last is print the invoice. Yes, this everything is done. Now, okay, now we have written here. We'll go, what should this particular item do? We'll check our documentation. What should this do? Whenever we say item, add the item to the catalog. That means what is the operation that we need to do? Add to cart function. Yes, where should I perform these operations all? In shopping cart class. Yes. First, I'll create a class shopping cart. Yes. Now I have the class. And what is the data is this particular taking, argument taking? Item. What is item here? Item is a class. Yes. So we again need to create a class for this. Class item. Yes. And according to him, what are the properties that this particular class item has? Name, quantity and price. So what kind should be name? String. Then next, quantity. Quantity we should be in integer. Quantity. Next, double. We'll go for double. Double, it can be float or double both. It's our requirement. I'll make them. Do you want to go for public or private?
Private.
Pure. Private. Yes. If we make them private, then we have to write, before that we will make a constructor also. In this constructor, what will be the arguments passed? String, name comma, int, quantity comma, double, price. Yes, I'll say this dot name equal to name, this dot quantity equal to quantity, next this dot price equal to price. Done. Now I need to have a public void getter. I need to have, right? It should be void or other type. Get name. The return type should be string. What this does? Return this dot name. Yes. Yeah, this is the thing. Now another getter is, I'll say quantity. Quantity is of int type. Quantity, yes. Another function is double. Yes or no? What is this? Price. Here I need to return quantity. Here I need to return price. Yes. I am using the constructor to set data to this particular object, and I am using get functions to get the data from those functions. Yes. We are done with this particular class of item. Next, user should be able to do the following operation. That means I need to write all these functions into shopping cart, right? Yes. So first, what is the first function that is present here? Yeah, what is the first function here? Add to catalog. Public. For this void or any other return statement that we have? Void. Yes. Void. Add to, so I'll copy from here. Add to catalog. The argument that it is taking is item, item, done with the function. What is the next function that I have? Add to cart. For this, is there any return type for adding? No. Cart of, I have written the function. Next is remove from cart. Public. Is there any return type? Remove the item from the cart. That is only a requirement. So do we have any return type? Void. Yes. Done. Next. Show cart. Displays all the items in the cart with item name and quantity. For show cart, do we have any return type? Yes. Okay. What is the return type? Okay. One second. Display all the items in the cart with item name and quantity. Whenever, okay, do you think we need to return it or just print it inside the function itself? If you print it also, it's enough, right? He's not asking to return a data. Yes, directly you can print there itself. So there is no return type. There might be few function which will be asking, but this function is not asking us to return something. Next, show catalog also. Displays all the items in the catalog with item name, quantity and price. Yes. For this also we don't have a return type. Done with it. Next is get total amount. What is this total amount? For this, do we have a return type? Calculate the total amount of the items in the cart. Why I need to call this particular function? Get total amount. What is my purpose? That means when whatever items I added to the cart, I need to know the price of it. That means this function should return something, right? For a user, from a user, he is asking the user wants to know what is the price. Yes. Then get total amount. What is it saying here? Okay. What does this word say here? Get. That means return something. The naming itself is specifying it. So you need to return. What will be the type for money? We placed price double, right? So it will be double get total amount. Yes. Next function is get payable amount. This is also gets the payable amount but deducts discount if any and add taxation to the total amount. We'll perform the operations later, but it is also saying get. That means it also have a return type. Does it have a return type? Yes. Public. As it is money, it's double. Get payable amount. That is done. Next, apply coupon is one more. Apply a coupon code. That means he's asking to apply a coupon. That's it. That means is he asking to return something? No, he's just asking us to perform coupon. Apply coupon to the amount. Public void apply coupon. This function is done. Next is print invoice. Print means it just need to print the, we don't have a return type, so print invoice. It will give us, when we ask for print invoice, it should print data in this way: item name, quantity and item price, total amount, discount amount, tax and payable amount. Yes, that should be the format. Yes, done with all the functions. Yes, now we'll go to our test case 1. In the test case 1, what is it saying? The first operation is item. What should item do? When I go for documentation again, when I say item, add the item to the catalog. He is asking us to add the item to the catalog. Where will this catalog be? Where should this catalog be? Why we are writing this shopping cart? What is the purpose for us to write this shopping cart? Yeah? To items. Okay, if you see Amazon or Flipkart or anything, what you'll be performing there? You'll add items, yes? Remove the items, you'll get to know the price, you'll have the invoice and everything. Similar to that, this class is there, shopping cart. That means the item will say add the item to the catalog. Catalog means whenever you want to add the item to your cart, you need to store it somewhere, right? How you'll be storing it? String array. Okay, whenever I say item, what is happening? Adding to the catalog. The function add to catalog should be performed. What is the argument that you're passing to add to catalog? Item. What is item? Item is a class. Yes. This item has how many attributes? If you see in a test case, when you say item, and it has more 3 arguments. That means you'll be passing the item, the functionality add to catalog, and then you are giving the product details. Yes? Yeah, where you need to store these details? In the shopping cart or item? Read this once. User should be able to do the following operations on the cart. What is cart here? Shopping cart. That means whenever you perform the operation of add to cart, where you need to store? Shopping cart itself. Yes. Now you need to add item to the catalog. Where you will be creating a catalog object? Variable, for example, a variable. In shopping cart itself. Yes, here he has given an example, an idea saying hint, catalog array. Why did he say catalog array? To store multiple items. Yes. So in our shopping cart class, I'll say public. What should be the type of this particular catalog variable? It should be int, string, boolean or item. Read these ones. What is he saying? Add the item to the catalog. That means what is the type of the catalog here? Item. So I'll say item and array. I'll say catalog. Done. Yes. Yeah, I have declared. Now I need to initialize it, right? Where will I be initializing it? Inside a constructor. Yes or no? So I'll say public shopping cart of. Does this constructor have any arguments to be passed? For now, no. Yes. So I'll say catalog equal to new item and base size of 10 I'll be giving. Now I'm creating an object to store multiple items into the catalog, but I need to have a count of how many number of items I'm adding, right? So I'll say public integer catalog count. Yes. Done. Yes or no? This is similar to your linked list. You can directly inherit linked list here, your list ADT also. But first solve like this and later try to implement list ADT on this also. Okay, by using list ADT also you can perform these operations. But we don't want to make it complex. We want you to understand the concept here. Yes? Understood? Now, do I have a default value to catalog count? I need to initialize it in constructor itself. So, I have done that also. Why did we come here? To perform the operation of add item to the catalog. Where is this happening in the add to catalog? Here. We can make it private, but it becomes complex here. That's why our main motto is to solve the problem first. Then we can go for private and public. Yeah, then you can solve. But there, check style comes secondary. You need to know how to solve a problem is the primary. Yes? Okay. Now what should I do? Now, okay, when will this particular function be called? Add to catalog. When add is given or item is given? When we go for test case, we were given only item. That means when item is there, I need to call that particular function. It is present in shopping cart, right? Shopping cart class. Scart equal to new shopping cart. I created the object. Now I need to call the scart dot add to cart function. What should be the argument that I should be passing? What argument should I pass from here? Tokens of 1 dot split of comma. Yes, will this work? Okay, add to cart function we have. When we go to catalog. Yes, add to catalog. When we go for add to catalog, what is the argument that it is expecting? what is the argument it is expecting? Item. Then what are we passing here? If we perform split operation on string, what will it be? Array of strings. What is add to catalog expecting? Item. What is item here? Item is a class which is taking 3 arguments as the constructor. So what I'll be doing is string array of data equal to, I'll say, I'll split the data first. Yes. Next. Directly data of 0, or I need to create an object for something? What is the argument add to catalog is expecting? Yeah. What is it expecting? Item. Then how do I create an item? Can I say new item here? New item. Yes. What will new keyword help me in performing? Creating an object for the item class. Yes. This is a constructor of item. How many arguments is it taking? 3. Yes, those are of type string, first one. According to him, one second, item, I'll say data of 0, comma, why I have to say integer dot parsing? The second argument that I am passing is of integer type. So I will say integer dot parse int of data of 1. Yes. Next one. Next is of price, which is of double type. Double dot parse double of data of 2. Yes. One second, guys. Yeah. Now add to catalog has a function. Now I pass 3 arguments to the item class, to the item constructor. I created an object and I am passing it. So I came here. Now what should I do next? How do I add items to my catalog? Can I say catalog of catalog count plus plus equal to item? Can I say that? Yes. Okay, that is done. Next operation. Okay, the first 5 are the same things that perform, that will be done. Next is catalog. Yeah, before going to that, is the requirement of this particular function done? Add to catalog. Yes. Yes or no? Yes. Okay, next function is catalog. What should it say? Catalog. Display all the items in the catalog. Where? Okay. How did you store your data into an integer array? One after the another. Here, what is the array type of catalog? Item. When are you creating an item for it? It will be created as an object, right? So you will directly storing the object into the index positions. Okay, right? Yeah. Next is catalog. I need to call the function scart dot catalog. Yes. Will it be done? No, the name is show catalog. show catalog. What should I do in this particular function? Show catalog. I need to display all the items present in it. How should I display? Display all the items in the catalog. I'll come to show catalog. Display all the items with item name and quantity. Only item name and quantity is required. No need of price.
Name, quantity and price. Show catalog.
Show. Oh, sorry. Name, quantity and price. The three things. What I need to do? Should I iterate through the array? Array of items for int I equal to 0, I less than catalog count I plus plus. Yes, here I'll say println of catalog of I dot. How do I access the variables inside catalog? What is okay? We are not using getters and setters. Okay, sorry. We are using getters and setters for items. So I'll say dot get name function plus space plus catalog of I dot get quantity function plus catalog of I dot get price, and this is the function. Yes, would it be enough for show catalog? Is the requirement done? What should he do? Show catalog, display all the items in the catalog with item name. Item name we are getting using getter function. Quantity we are getting using getter, and price also we are getting using get function. Yes, yeah. If we go for a test case, our catalog is also done. Now another function that we have is add. What does add do? Add an item to the cart. Cart is also a, what is the hint given here? Cart array. Where should I store these details? Where should I need to store the cart details when I want to add an item to the cart? Create a
class.
Okay, one second before going to that. When you see add here, what is the purpose of this add function? Read it out. Cart. Yes, that item is a class already. I need to store multiple items. Where I can store multiple items of same type? Yes, previously we have created an array for catalog. Similar to that, we need to create an array for of item type for only cart. Yes, and here's again how many number of elements you will be adding. As we are using arrays, we need to have how many items we are adding to the cart. So cart, that would be more complex than this. Okay, tell your idea about class. How do you want to store into a class? Okay, we, you created a class called cart. In cart, yes. Yes. Okay. Where? Yes. Where you will be creating the cart array? Yeah, that's where I created it. Again, you are coming. Yeah. Okay, we can directly go and say create an object for item. But you want to create a class called cart, and in it you want to create an object for item, and then it's like circle going circle. You directly have an item over there. You can directly create an object, right? why you should go for a class called cart. You'll be doing the same thing here also. You'll be creating an object for the cart. Yes, you are using extra class. In that you are storing again item itself. Is there anything different from this that we'll be doing? We'll be performing the same operations. Okay, we'll be going through. If you can support your statement saying we want to use a class for cart, we'll go through that also later. Okay. Now I created a cart count also. I declared them. I need to initialize them, right? So cart equal to new item of size base 10. And cart count equal to, initially I'm giving size of, sorry, 0. Yes, done with that. And for add function, I'll go to test case once. In this test case, okay, I'll come to add here. From here, which function should I call whenever I come across add function? Adds an item to the cart. Which function tells that operation? Add to cart function. So from here I'll say scart dot add to cart. And what is the object type here? Item. Yes. How should we create an item here again? Yeah. By using again new item, I'll create an object for new item. Here I'll say, similar to previous one, I'll create a array and split it. Yes, I already have data variable here, so no need of again creating it. So I'm splitting here and I'll be passing arguments. One second, I'll come here. In my test case, when I split these two, what will be the arguments present here? Data of 0 will be curd and data of 1 will be 19. Yes, but item has 3 arguments, right? How should we do that? We will be creating another constructor for item where public item of string name comma int quantity. I'll say this dot name equal to name, this dot quantity equal to quantity itself, and for price I'll by default give 0 as the value because we are not passing any argument here. Yes or no? Name. Yes, there is no argument passed for this constructor, so by default I'm giving 0 as the value for that. Yes, you need to give a value for price, though it is not initialized. For everything, there should be a default value, right? If there is... Yes. Okay. Right, we came to... Yes, we have item here. How should I pass the arguments here again? Data of 0, yes. Comma next is... integer dot parse int of data of 1. Yes. Now I'll go to add to cart function. What I need to do here? Where I need to add the items? Cart of cart count plus plus equal to item. Yes, would it be enough? Yes, our requirement is done. Next, show. What does show function do? Show, display all the items in the cart. Yes, when I go to show function, what I should say? display all items in the cart. So I'll iterate through the existing int I equal to 0, I less than cart count I plus plus. Yes, I'll say println of for this, what should I display? I'll go to show function once. Show cart. Item name and quantity. As we are storing only those two, it should print cart of 0 dot get name plus cart of, sorry, here I it should be, sorry, cart of I dot get quantity. Yes, done. Our requirement for show cart is done. Yeah, next thing I need to perform is, what is the next test case that we have? Total amount. What is the total amount function? We'll go to the documentation. Total amount, display the total amount. We'll go and see the, okay, before that, did we make a function call to this particular function, show cart? Yes, we'll come here, scart dot show cart function. We are not passing anything. Next function is total amount. Now get total amount, calculate the total amount for the items in the cart. Get means this function should return something. That means when we call the function scart dot get total amount, it will return us the value. So what I'll say is, I'll print it here. Yes, whatever it calculates and gives, I will print it. Now I'll go to get total amount. Where is get total? I'm here. From where should I calculate this total? Calculate the total amount for the items in the cart. That means I need to iterate through the cart array. Yes, for int I equal to 0, I less than cart count I plus plus. Yes, done. Now here I need to find the total. Do I have something to store? That means I'll say double total equal to 0 initially. I'll say total plus equal to, how should I calculate? Cart of I, I'll be getting, right? By cart of I, I'll get the items present in the cart. Yes, for this cart, what is the price? Dot get prices. In the cart, what data are we storing? Are we storing price for cart? No. Then where should I get the price from?
Catalog means that. Catalog the price.
Yes. Then how should I get the price? I need to get from my catalog. So how do I get the data from the catalog? How do I know whether a specific element is, that means I need to know the price of each egg. That means you need to iterate through the items in the catalog also, right? As this is the computer, we cannot say directly. So I'll say int j equal to 0, j less than catalog count j plus plus. What I should do here? Where do I? When we are adding to the cart, one second. Add. Here, do we have a price here? That's what I've done. But what should this particular function do? What should this add function do? It should add your items to a cart array. What should item do? It should add to the catalog. Two different arrays. How will you get the price then? Yes or no? That's why we'll be iterating through the for loop. And here I'll say if catalog of J dot get name dot equals of cart of I dot get name. Yes, if it is true, I'll cut this up. I'll come here, I'll paste it and say total equal to total plus, what should I say here? Catalog of J dot get price. But yes, I'm getting the price. Is it done? I'll get price for one egg. If that means, for example, I'll be storing each egg's price is 5 rupees, but I have 20 eggs. Then how do I calculate it? I need to multiply the quantity also, right? So I'm getting the price from catalog, but quantity from where should I get it? From cart only I should get, not from catalog. So I'll say cart of I dot get quantity. Yes, here I did not make a function call. Yes, done. Will I get all my correct answer? Yes or no? Now done with iteration. Now I'll say return total. Yeah, requirement of a function. What is a function here? Total amount. Display the total amount. We calculated the total amount here and we are returning it. After returning in this function, I am displaying it. Done with that also. What is the next test item present? Remove function. Yes, for remove function he is passing 2, name of the product and as well as the quantity. Here yes cart dot remove. For remove, what is the name of the function? Remove from cart is the name of the function. Remove from cart of, okay, one second. What is the argument that remove from cart is accepting? Item. As we have seen, he is giving name and quantity. So what we'll do, from above we'll copy this to, okay, this one line to split the data, and then I'll be creating an item here. What are the arguments that should be passed? Data of 0, comma integer dot parseInt of data of 1. Yes. Now I made a function call with this data. Now I'll go to remove from cart function. Where is remove from cart? Now I have here. Here, from where should I remove the item? From cart. So I need to iterate through the for int I equal to 0, I less than cart count I plus plus. Yes, done. Here what should I say? There are two scenarios where if, for example, I added 10 eggs to my cart, but I want to remove only 4 eggs. So what is the logic for that? Okay, before that, how you will find out which item is in your cart? You need to write a if condition, right? Cart of I dot get name dot equals of item dot get name function. If this is true, then only you'll go inside. Yes? Yes or no? The scenario is, there are two scenarios. One is, I have 10 eggs, I want to remove 4 eggs from them. So, first case is, I need to remove the number of eggs, reduce the number of eggs. Another scenario is, if I want to remove 10 by 10 eggs, then I need to remove the egg item itself from the cart array. For now, we'll be writing to reduce the number of eggs from the cart. So now this is equal. Then what should I do? Cart of I dot, here I have to reduce the quantity of it, right? So how should I do? Do I have a function to reduce the, can I say just quantity? What is cart of I type? It is item type. In item, quantity is private. Can we make changes to it? Yes or no? We cannot. So we need to write a setter for this. Public set quantity, set quantity. I'll get an argument from here. Int quantity. One second. Public void. Yes. Now this should say quantity dot quantity equal to quantity. Yes. I want to make changes to the number of elements eggs present in the cart. Yes or no? As my quantity variable is private, can I access that particular variable?
No.
That's why I have written setter function, and in that setter function I'll be passing the argument how much I want to assign to that. So this dot quantity is replaced by new quantity. From the function here, what I should say? Set quantity. Yes? In this, what is the argument that I need to pass? I have 10 eggs initially. Now I should remove 4. What should its value become? 6. But how the... Okay, that you got 6 because I have 10 existing. I need to reduce 4. 10 minus 4 is 6. How will you get to know the value of 10 here? Cart of I dot get quantity minus item dot get quantity. Yes, done. That will help you to perform the operation. Yes or no? Yes, this will help you in reducing the quantity of the items present in the cart. Done with it. One requirement, that means I have 10x, I need to reduce by 4. So it became 6 now. I have situation where I want to remove 10 by 10x. How should I perform that operation? When? That means here, can I say if after setting the data, cart of I dot get quantity function equal to 0, I have to remove the operation. Yes. What I'll say is int position equal to 0 first, and I'll have a flag equal to 0. In this, what I'll say is flag equal to 1 as well as position equal to I, because I am in a for loop. Every time I cannot go inside and perform the operation, right? Yes. If not, I can do there itself. Should I perform the operation here itself? Yes. Okay. What we'll do is, I need to iterate through the From where should I iterate? But if I make changes, this is an array. The changes will be reflected, right? Are you able to follow this particular point, what I'm explaining? Okay. Now, if the quantity is equal to 0, you need to remove the element from the cart. Yes? If I perform the operation of removing an item from the cart here itself, what will happen? This is an array. Yes or no? So, due to the concept of aliasing, the data might be misled. Yes or no? So, what I'll do is, by making use of position and flag here, by making use of position, I'll find out where this particular element is there that I want to remove. So, I can find out using I. And to say that this quantity is 0, I'll say flag equal to 1. And I'll break from the loop. Because I'm passing only one item. If one item is there, I'll just go inside and perform the operation. Yes? So, after coming out of the loop, I'll say if flag equal to 1. What does flag equal to 1 say? You should remove the item. So, here I'll iterate through the cart again. I equal to 0. I less than cart count. I plus plus. I'll say cart of, no, here I will not be this, I will be position. I have three elements, I have eggs, bread and oil. Eggs is at first, egg is at zero position, bread is at one, oil is at two. Now your eggs are 0, so you need to overlap, you need to shift all the right side element to the left side. So what I'll be doing here is cart of I equal to cart of I plus 1. I perform the operation. Yes, after this is happened, I moved 2 positions to the left, so the last element I need to make it a default. Yes. So, I'll say cart of cart count minus 1. Yes? Minus 1 equal to 0 or null. What is cart type? Cart is object. So, for objects, it should be null. Yes or no? Done. And then I need to reduce the size of cart also, right? Cart count minus minus. I am removing the element, so I need to reduce the number of elements present in the cart. Now both our requirements are completed here. In both the scenarios, where I just need to reduce the quantity of it, or if the items I want to remove completely. Both the cases are fulfilled. Yes, should we move forward? Before going that, we'll again recheck it. Remove the item from the cart. Did that process complete here? Yes. If it is only based upon the quantity, it will be finished in this particular highlighted area. If the size, the quantity is 0, then I am, by using position and flag, here I'll just remove the element from the item from the cart. Done with it. What is the next one that I have? Show. Show we already written. Total amount is already written. Remove. We have written above. So, this also works here. Show is all already done. Total amount is done. Payable amount is not done. Okay. What does payable amount do? Payable amount. Display the payable amount. What is the function that it will be calling? Get payable amount. Gets the payable amount by deducing discount. If any, and add tax 15% to the total amount. Yes, so we'll come here, we'll say scart of escort dot get payable amount, and this should be in the print statement. Yes, as we are getting the data. Done. We'll go to the function get payable amount. What should happen here? According to what he has saying, get the payable amount. Sorry. Gets the payable amount by deducing the discount, if any. Did we come across anywhere the discount function? For this we did not come across. So whenever we come across, we'll include that. Here before that, and I need to and add tax 15% to the total amount of items in the count. From where will I get the total amount? Get total amount will return me. Yes, I have a function already, get total amount function. If I make a function call to that, it will return. So I'll store the data somewhere. I'll say amount equal to get total amount. Yes or no? Now here, for now we don't have any discount applicable, so we'll not discount, we'll write a comment here, discount, ignoring for now. Next, what is the next thing that we have to do? 15% tax. We have to add tax 15% to the amount that is present. So we'll say amount plus equal to amount divided by 100. What will this expression do? It will give me 1% amount into, I'll say 15%. Yes or no? I'm in this parenthesis, I'm reducing my amount to 1%, and I'm multiplying it with the 15% amount. Now I got it. Now what should I do? I should return it, right? Return amount. Done. Yes, we can perform that also. This also works, but just to understand. Anyway, you can perform the operation. Yes. Now, if we go for a test case, get payable amount is also done. What is the next thing that we have to do?
Print.
Print means? Print invoice is the function that we need to make a call. So we'll come down. Yes, cart. Dot print invoice, sorry, print invoice function. Yes, is it returning anything? Print invoice, are we returning some data from print invoice? We are not returning anything, we just need to print the data. Yes, in the same function. So I'll come here. What I need to print here? Whenever I make a function call, it should say, first statement should be this, according to his output, println of, the double quotes, yes, this is of 3 spaces, 1, 2, 3, yes, 1, 2, 3 is done. Next, after that, what are these?
Items
that are? The items that are present in the cart. So what you need to do, for I should iterate through the
cart.
I less than cart count, I plus plus. Here what am I printing here? From here, cart of I dot get name function plus space plus cart of I dot get quantity function plus next thing is, what is the next thing that we have to do? Price.
Get payable.
Price for each item, right? Yes. Okay. Can we get the data from cart of I dot get price? Why? We are not storing there. So from where should I get it? Again, I need to get from the catalog. Yes. So here I'll again iterate through the catalog. Int j equal to 0, j less than catalog count, yes, j plus plus. Here I'll say if cart of I dot get name function dot equals of catalog of j dot get name. Sorry, if this is true, then I want to print it. Yes, here what should I say? Get price from which variable? Catalog of j dot get price function. Yes, I'll get all my data right there. Yes or no? Yes, that operation is done. Now again, what he is asking, okay, once we'll open the test case output also once. Yes, this is our output, this is our input. Whenever we say print, we printed this particular data here, that is done. Next, we are printing the items from the cart here, this statement is done. Now I need to print the total. So what I'll do is, I'll say println of copy paste total here plus get total amount, right? Yes or no? Yes, total amount we have got. What is the next statement that we have here? Discount in percentage. Though we don't have percentage, what we have to do? We have to print 0.0 for now. Okay, we'll do it manually. When we come across the test case, for the next test case, we'll do it. This is done. Next thing is tax. What is the tax that we need to calculate? Tax plus, yeah, on what should I calculate the tax? According to him, it is 738. How will I get the value of 738? Get total amount into, okay, you want to go for 0.15. That will print your data, right? Taxable amount. That is done. Next thing is, what is the payable amount? Paste plus payable amount. How will I get? Get payable amount function. Yes or no? Now we'll compile it. Okay, we came across errors. Case cut, add catalog. 139. Add to cart. What is it saying? Add to cart is accepting only item and double, that means two variables, but we are passing three variables. Why is it saying like that? We have two constructors, right? For what? Yes, okay. What is happening here? Add to cart. Actual and formal arguments is different length. Line number 139. From 139, which function are we calling? Add to catalog. Add to catalog has 1, 2. Why do I have 2 arrays? Okay. 1 second. I had extra parentheses here. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Compile. Yes. No errors. Okay, now I'll come here, I'll say input Should I print here itself or to output file? out1.txt. Okay, I'll go to out1.txt. Yes, this is the output that I am getting. If I see my output 1 and I'll compare this with that, copy, control F, paste. Something is missing. What is missing? Total amount. Okay, here, yeah, when we are printing our total amount and payable amount, we are just printing the prices, but he is expecting us to print these also, total amount. Yes, here, copy paste, total amount is done and payable amount. For payable amount also, we'll say, yes, payable amount, compile and re-execute. Minimize this file. This is my output, this is my input. Copy, control F, paste. Yes, everything is matching. For first test case, nothing failed. Yes, it's already 3. Should we start again after this? Yes.